Hello, I'm Marcus Boston. Quick video today. Did it seem like, or does it seem like, your doctors are hiding the cause of your baby's HIE diagnosis? Want to know what I'm getting at? Stay with me as I share with you this really important information. I had an opportunity recently to talk with some parents, and these parents were reaching out because their baby has an HIE diagnosis. And along the way, throughout this process, the parents have been in contact with the doctors and everything and trying to figure out, okay, what is this diagnosis and what types of challenges will their baby face going into the future? And it was something really interesting that was going on along the way. When mom and dad were trying to figure out, okay, how did we get here? What caused my baby to have this HIE diagnosis? They were kind of getting a runaround on that. That was a question that they just were not able to get answers to. Like I said, there were a lot of answers for the diagnosis and what is going into the future, challenges and how it may manifest itself, all of that stuff, fine. But the cause and what this went on and did was, especially for mom, it caused a lot of confusion for her. And she began to blame herself, and she began to be in a pretty bad place emotionally, because what she defaulted to was, well, they're not telling me because maybe it was something that I did. And what ended up happening is, as they were going through this process, it wasn't until the family spoke with another medical professional. And this professional began to talk with them about the causes of HIE, hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. And I guess this is a good little breaking point to help you understand, okay, from a simplistic standpoint, what is HIE? It is essentially a reduced level of blood and oxygen, which can lead to a brain injury. And so as this family was talking to this other medical professional, as they begin to Google HIE and the causes of HIE, that is when they begin to question what was going on. And so that is the purpose of today's video, especially if you're a mother and you're watching this video and it feels like you're in that same spot. Nobody's telling you about the cause. And so what you can have is, HIE can be caused by a number of ways. You could have a situation in which something happens during development, during the baby's development, which leads to a reduced level of blood and oxygen. You can have some genetic abnormalities, which can lead to a reduced level of blood and oxygen. Mom can have some things going on during her pregnancy, infections and running fevers and a whole host of other things that can occur for mom that can lead to problems for the baby. But where all of this stuff gets thrown out of whack is, what happens when you don't have genetic issues? What happens when there aren't any developmental issues? What happens when mom had a pretty much uneventful pregnancy, followed all of the doctor's orders and, you know, met her appointments and all of that? There were no problems. And to even take it a step further, when mom presents at the hospital, they do some imaging or some sonogram or some early testing, baby is fine. So how do you go from that end to the other end, which is an HIE diagnosis? And so there's this other area of causation for HIE, which some doctors, they're not really going to talk with families about, and that is birth trauma. In other words, something happens during labor and delivery in which doctors and nurses, they drop the ball. And by dropping the ball, that is what causes the baby to have that reduced level of blood and oxygen, which leads to a brain injury. Now, during labor and delivery, doctors and nurses, they have tools that they can use to help them understand how well your baby is tolerating that vaginal delivery. They've got the electronic fetal heart monitor that's there, and that is looking at a lot of things. I've done other videos that have talked about the electronic fetal heart monitor, but just to sum it up, what it's doing is it's helping doctors and nurses look at your baby's well-being, how well your baby is tolerating that vaginal delivery. And so when you have certain things on the electronic fetal heart monitor, for example, if you've got a monitor and you've got strips that are not reassuring to the doctors, well, then they've got to do something. So, you know, the purpose of today's video is to help you understand that other way in which HIE can be caused. And it has nothing to do with parents, especially mom, it's got nothing to do with you. It's something that the doctors and the nurses, they missed it. And by missing that fetal distress, let's say for example, by not properly diagnosing the fetal distress, then we move on to not properly treating the fetal distress, and then the baby's fetal reserves become depleted, and now you've got a brain injury because that reduced level of blood and oxygen has went on too long. Baby can no longer compensate. Baby's not getting help from the doctors and the nurses, and now you've got a brain injury. So for that treatment piece, when it's looking like baby's in serious trouble, baby needs help, doctors have to move to an emergency C-section. And when we can find problems, like I said, on that fetal heart monitor, there are issues that were missed, then the doctors and the nurses, they either failed to do an emergency C-section when they should have, or they waited too long to move to the emergency C-section. And by that time, the baby has already suffered a brain injury. If you have more questions, you would like to talk with me about an investigation into what happened during your labor and delivery, or you've got other questions about the challenges that your baby's going to meet going into the future, especially the financial aspect of things, there is a phone number on the screen. Go ahead and pick up the phone and give me a call. I talk with families all the time about hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, cerebral palsy, CP, meconium aspiration syndrome, MAS, shoulder dystocia, which leads into a brain injury, and shoulder dystocia, that's just when the baby gets stuck and during a vaginal delivery and umbilical cord can get compressed, and that can also cause a baby to have an HIE diagnosis. So if you've got this type of stuff going on and you would like to speak with me, pick up the phone and give me a call. Before I get out of here, I want to make sure that you understand that if you are not in Maryland, I practice law in the state of Maryland, that if you are somewhere else and this is something that we think we might be able to assist you with, we have to use attorneys in your area. It's called co-counseling or using local counsel. That's what we call it. So we would have to do something like that if you're not in Maryland and you call my office. That's going to be it for today's quick educational video. Again, I'm Marcus Boston, and I'm one of the childbirth injury and medical malpractice attorneys practicing law here in the state of Maryland at Boston Law Group, LLC. See you next time. Take care. Enjoy the rest of your day.